ago. So, Leanne. Hi, Leanne.
Hi, Han. How are you going? Thank you for allowing me to come on your show.
Oh, another Australian.
Oh my yes, God. Definitely.
Okay. Yeah. I remember your cute little face. Aren't you a reader?
Aww. Thank you. Yes, I am.
Yeah. You're such a sweetheart. I love your readings.
Oh, thank you. And I've been loving watching your shows too. And I literally just flick Facebook pretty much on and you were there. And I'm like, I got work to do, but I need to watch for a little while. Oh, so
I need to know right away. Do you have December or March around you, honey?
March, yes. My husband's birthday. Okay. I've got a couple of passings in March as well.
Yeah, it's just the feeling I get around you as a three. So if it's not December being the 12th month, it's March being the third month. So 1 + 2 = 3, right? And yeah. The numbers equaling 3 would be, just to get them out of the way, 3, 12, 21, or 30. Okay. I don't know if someone's had to make some decisions around you. Oh my God, what am I going to do? Oh my goodness, I think I have to do this. But they make you feel that you're pondering.
Yep. Sorry, I forgot to turn my phone on silent. Sorry, honey, I just missed that last little bit.
That's okay. I love dancing. But they make you feel like having to make some kind of decision, you know, pondering some kind of decision. But they make me feel like you're on the right track. Can I ask you a silly goofy question? Did you just have a deja vu just like recently?
A deja vu?
Yeah, like you know when you've been somewhere and you go, oh my freaking God, I've been here before.
I do that quite often. Yeah. I'll go places or speak to people and think, oh my God, I've spoken to you before, but I don't know who you are. So I put it down to past life sort of stuff.
Well, no, they just make you feel the stuff that you're planning in your lifetime. So for me, you're on the right track. A deja vu for me is a dream that you've had. But the thing is, you're just, because you're in such a deep state of, you know, unconsciousness when you're sleeping, sometimes your subconscious, your unconscious subconscious being doesn't remember a dream, depending on when you went to bed, that kind of thing. And so what happens is when you wake up, you won't remember the dream, but you'll go somewhere and you go, okay, I've been here before. It's because you visited in a dream. So for me, they're gentle reminders that you're on the right track. Now, I don't know if you've decided like to let go of something to improve another area of your life, but they make you feel that's a good idea. So when you're going to doing that, I'm not quite sure, but they make me feel that you're taking the necessary steps to move ahead and to freaking get it done. So I'm really happy for you. I'm going to congratulate you already because they make me feel that there's balloons and celebrations around you.
Oh, excellent. I've made some big decisions in this last probably month and really put some things to committed to something in the last week that is going to bring big change. So,
about it, so I'm really, really happy for you in a nice way.
Oh, yeah, I'm excited.
Now, I'm excited too. Now, sometimes building up takes a bit, so don't worry about the first few months if you're not doing what it is that you think you're supposed to. Think of a grass fire, okay? Think of that fire just taking off and just like burning like crazy. Because the thing is, that's basically what's going to happen, but it needs to give some time. You need to nurture, you need to water your seeds so that they'll grow, right? So for me, I feel like a lot of decisions and like, oh my God, what the freak am I going to do? You know? So I'm really happy that you're kind of pulling within yourself to do your pros and your cons and to weigh things out, because it makes me feel that you've done all of that, you know?
Yep.
So
Oh, that totally makes sense. Thank you so much, Hannah. And I'm at that stage where now I've got to be accountable for it all sort of thing, and it's going to take a bit of groundwork, but it's going to spread quite quickly.
I think you're going to be okay. Yeah, exactly. Wildfire. Yeah. So who passed in March that's talking to me?
I've got a grandfather and a great-grandmother that both passed in March.
Okay.
So mother and son. Yeah.
Who would have had an aneurysm or maybe even a stroke?
My grandfather had a couple before he died and then passed with a heart attack.
Oh, okay. It's just to show me strokes. And is there somebody that died around 8:15 in the morning?
My grandmother. Yes, okay. My grandmother. But that was January.
Yeah, but it's 8:15, it looks like, or 8:20 a.m. is what it
exactly. It was quarter past eight. I got the phone call at 8:30 to say that she had passed.
Yeah. But she passed at 8:15 is what she tells me.
Yeah, she did.
Who has the nosebleed?
My daughter does occasionally. That's still here.
Is she like stressed out over something?
Yeah, she is. She's working long hours.
Yeah, she's going to be okay. But you know what? Like, she eats too many chips.
She does. She wanted pizza and chips for tea last night. Then she went to the gym and decided just to have pizza, not chips.
Yeah, but the thing, we're talking about too many chips.
Okay.
So she doesn't just have to watch her chips. She can have chips, but not so many, they said.
Yeah. Okay. It's a quick, easy meal for her because she's always rushing around working and uni and boys and all that sort of stuff. Makes a lot of sense.
She's got good things coming, but she worries just a little bit too much. But you know what? She's going to be all right.
Yeah. Yeah. She's got a head screwed on that one.
Yeah. So that's really good. Who had a Chihuahua dog or it could be like a Pomeranian, like a very hairy little freaking dog?
My grandfather. And then when he went into a retirement village, we took it for him. It was like a Maltese cross, but white, really hairy, curly hair.
Hairy little dog and really yippy too, like really barks a lot.
Yeah, Pee-wee, his name was.
Oh, he's freaking loud.
It was.
Oh, my God. Just like, almost sound like Dino from the freaking Flintstones, you know?
I love
that. Was there somebody born around Halloween, like just maybe a week before or a week after?
That's October for you guys, isn't it? Because we don't really celebrate it much here. My daughter is the 10th of October.
Oh,
my youngest daughter.
10-10. Okay. But anyways, they follow her around a lot. So it's in the month of Halloween or around Halloween, just either before or just after. But anyways, she's got to be tell her not to worry so much, honey. But thank you so much, Leanne, for dropping by.
Thank you.
Do that all the way from. See, my two lives so far, I've had two Australians. I have to move there now. It's nice. There's
Why not? Come and visit at least. It's beautiful.
I do want to go do a show there, you know, and it would be so exciting to be there. Yeah.
Well, so if you come to South
about going to the UK, actually, today, someone asked me to do like something out there, but I don't know, like it's. I'm just so excited to be in but Australia, I feel so at home there.
South Australia because we get missed out a lot with mediums and stuff. They all go to Melbourne, Sydney and that side of it. So if you come to South Australia, come to Adelaide, let me know and I'll help spread the word.
Oh, would that be awesome? That'd be lots of fun. I'd be sleeping the first 3 days I'm there. There's such a time.
Yeah, beautiful. Well, thank you so much, honey, for your beautiful messages and sharing your gift.
Take care, honey.
Right. You too. Bye.
Bye.